Well, this week we've been bringing you stories from the tornado that struck New Hampshire back in 2008, and today is in fact the five-year anniversary.
The images were something many people never thought they would see here in New Hampshire. A 50-mile path of damaged homes and property and shattered dreams.
Now, one of the most tragic yet touching stories from that day is of Brenda Stevens and her 2-month-old grandson. Brenda lost her life in the tornado, but the little boy she was holding survived. Our Amy Covino spoke to the family and met the infant back then.
And tonight we meet him again, and he's now 5 years old.
Buddy. Banged his head up a little bit. He's got a couple good war wounds there on his knuckles. His knuckles got it a little bit too, but short of that, he made it okay.
A miracle baby, a symbol of hope in the face of so much loss and destruction. John Paul survived, and today... is thriving. John Paul is 5 now and a big brother himself. Julianne Jean was born July 25th, 2010, 2 years and 1 day after the tornado. Her middle name, a tribute to the grandmother she'll never meet. Brenda Jean Stevens was killed in the tornado. The memory, now 5 years old, still brings pain.
About that day, I just kind of told him how lucky he was that his grandmother, you know, loved him so much and held on to him and managed to save him.
Jeremy Stevens had wrapped up work in Litchfield, doubled back to clean up the work site, a move he thinks kept him and his eldest son, Justin, out of the path of the tornado by just a couple of minutes.
Dad was just picking me up.
Just picking you up. I just tell him it was a real rough day.
And he swimmed in the water to come
and
get
me. Yeah.
Jeremy glosses it over, but the roads were impassable, trees down everywhere. So he got out on foot and hiked, ran, and swam across part of Northwood Lake to get to his father's house and his new baby.
Daddy swam, he wanted to get to you fast. He was scared. And how big were you?
John Paul is right, a tiny survivor, a heroic grandmother, and one very grateful daddy, then and now.
She held on to him right to the very end until she couldn't do it anymore. The tornado was just was powerful and pulled them away.
A month after the tornado, Jeremy remembers walking across a woodlot on the other side of the lake and finding something unexpected and personal.
I found his bassinet still made, his little bed, the pillow, and it was crazy. It never didn't even affect it. The pillow, the blanket, everything, just the way I made it that morning.
5 years later, the house, leveled by the twister, is standing once again. Same footprint, same spot. The Stevens are carpenters and framers and family first kind of folks, reluctant to accept help even in the most dire of times.
I guess I got everything I need right here, you know what I mean? And that's just friends and family that have been there to help. And I guess I really don't need anything else because I have everything I need. But.
John Paul will start kindergarten in the fall. He's confident and busy. And surrounded by love, just like he was the day the tornado struck, and the day after, when big brother Justin tried to help feed him.
Okay, you want to help? You want to help?
On your mark, get set, go!
And Brenda's namesake, Julianne Jean, refuses to let those brothers of hers leave her behind. A vibrant, adorable reminder that life goes on, but the Stevens family will never, ever forget the woman who gave her life for this one. In Northwood, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.